Hi, in this video we're going to look at pushing calendar, task, and note items from FileMaker to Outlook. We assume that the plugin is already installed and registered. Here on the left I have FileMaker, on the right I have Outlook. I'm going to go ahead on Outlook and navigate to my calendar month view. Let's go back to the demo here and get ready to push a calendar event. We can see here I have the start date, start time, end date, end time, a subject, and a busy status. And this is what it'll look like. I'm going to go ahead and insert this date. And you can see here immediately it shows up along with its correlating reminder, how that works. Much like the other video, if you've looked at it already, where we push a contact from FileMaker to Outlook, calendar works almost identically. In fact, once you learn the technique, it becomes easy to do any other module. So I'm going to enter a calendar event from FileMaker to Outlook. I do my typical scripts to do the housekeeping, check if the plugin is there, check to see that we're authenticated. Then we open the folder using the command PCEM open folder, and we're designating a particular type of folder, in this case calendar. We then call the new record command, which keeps a record in waiting. Then we set the various fields with the various criteria to get the information on where the details are and what to set, what they're called, and some of the rules and restrictions. You'll want to refer to our fields and functions guide available on our documentation site. And that documentation, by the way, is available right here under the doc library. So just navigate to the doc library. It'll bring you to our site, and you can find the document under Outlook Fields and Functions. So we set the fields here, and then we save the record, check for errors, and go on. If all went well, we'll get an ID back. So I have here sample event from FileMaker. Let me open this up again if I can. Now, if I want to edit that, I could do sample event 2 from FileMaker, and you can see immediately it updates right here in Outlook. I'll go ahead and close that. Let's go ahead and view it so I can view an event once it's added and once I have that ID, and then I can also delete it. So let's go look at the edit event, calendar event. Edit. Okay, so we do the normal housekeeping routines here, and then you can see that I'm calling the open record command. I'll be grabbing the ID from FileMaker and opening the given record, setting the fields as if I was creating a new one, but just resetting them, and this is where the edit actually takes place, and then the save record will save those changes, check for errors, and be done. All right, so that's the edit. Let's go look at the view. I think it's called display. So go ahead and display the calendar. Much simpler. All we need to do is call the open record with the appropriate ID, and then once we have that pointer, if you will, or that placeholder, we can call the PCEM display, and that command works like that. And then we'll look at the delete, calendar delete. Another simple command, regular housekeeping, delete record, provide it with the ID. So long as it all went well, the record will delete, and then all we're doing here is clearing the Outlook ID in the event that it worked. We clear the Outlook ID not to confuse the process. All right, so now talking about deleting, let's go ahead and do that. There, I've just deleted the calendar. Now tasks are almost identical in the way that they work. So let's go ahead and navigate to the task area of our Outlook profile here. I don't have any tasks at the moment, so let's go ahead and insert one. There's my sample task item. I can edit that. Okay, let's go ahead and edit that. And you'll see that it edits it. And then I can view it. And it did bring up the task. Just had the screen set a little big. But there it is. And then I can delete it. These scripts work almost identical. Let's just go see what one difference there is really between tasks and calendar events. And when I enter a task, the only real difference, besides of course the fields, each folder or module has different fields that it needs to use, but the only real difference is what folder I open to establish, okay, which module am I talking to. but the rest of it is identical. New record, set field, save record, and so on. So building these things are rather quick in terms of once you understand one, you really understand them all. Likewise, the edit in Outlook for tasks is identical in many ways, and the delete is identical as well. All right, so that's the calendar and the tasks. Notes. Notes, again, almost the same thing there. Let's go ahead and get ready to push a note. And I'll locate my note area here in Outlook. I'm using 2016. And here's a note that I want to add. Insert it. Notes are real easy because it's basically just one field. Let's go ahead and edit that note. Okay, and there I've edited the note. And I can go ahead and delete that note. The script there is very similar, except I have a lot less fields to edit. In fact, in this case, it's only the body. That's the actual name of the field that creates the details in that note. Yeah, so when I add a new note, you can see that really there's only one field that I'm working with. Open folder, new record, body, set it to note, done. That concludes details on how to add, edit, delete, and view calendar, tasks, and notes.
To learn more, contact us at sales@productivecomputing.com or visit our website, www.productivecomputing.com. Thank you for watching.